I'm Jill Kebb with Plant Life Journey. In this morning yin yoga practice, I invite you to connect to your breath. That nice ujjayi breathing, which you hear in the back of your throat. So take a nice inhale, and on your exhale, have an audible H-A ha, kind of like a Darth Vader sound. So then when you close your mouth to breathe through your nose, on your exhale, you can hear that sound, kind of like the wind or an ocean wave in the back of your throat. I also invite you to dedicate your yoga practice to someone or something that is just important to you. So take a moment here to connect to your breath and consider your dedication. For this class, just a pillow. If you have a block or a bed pillow, that might be helpful. Sitting up tall, bring one of your heels in on an angle, 90 degree angle. You can also make this a wider angle if you like. We're just going to fold over the leg here, and so no kind of force is needed in yin. We're just taking a nice longer, we'll be in each pose about 3 to 5 minutes. So sitting up tall, connecting to your breath, connecting to your dedication for your practice, and exhale, come over the leg. If you decide you like your pillow, you know, underneath your leg, maybe underneath your bum here to just help raise you up a little bit, that might be a good place for your pillow. And then just settle in here. Just connect to your breath. And as your mind wanders, come back to your dedication or your breath. There's no need to push yourself in yin. You want to come to that edge of effort and ease. And just breathe into it. Bent here. Don't want to lock our knees. Yin really allows us to get into the deep muscles and the fascia. So it's really good to help with flexibility over time. And nice to have this sort of meditative calming practice of yin. It's a good time to check in with your body. Listen in. Notice what's going on inside of your body as you come back to that ujjayi breath.
your next inhale, slowly walk your hands back up.
And switch sides. I'm turning, but you don't need to. Just bring your other heel in towards your middle, sit up tall, take a nice inhale, and lower over your leg. Again, feel free to use your pillow under your bum, under your leg, maybe right here in front of you, wherever you like to place it. Come back to your breath or your intention and dedication for this morning's practice. Relax your face, relax your jaw, and just breathe. Your next inhale, bring your hands down, walk them back up, and come to a lying down position. Bring one leg across the other. My left is over my right. I'll scoot my hips a little bit towards the left, keeping my shoulder blades on the mat. To just allow my legs to move to the opposite direction, so in this case to my right side. You can have the pillow here under your knees, it could be on this side of you, whichever makes you feel more comfortable. Again, aiming to keep your shoulders connected to the mat. Feel where you are connected to the earth here. And just allow for your spine to have that nice twist opener as we just breathe into this nice final twist. You can also look to the opposite side with your head. like you're not getting enough stretch. Or you can also elongate your top leg and perhaps put your pillow under there. So many options. Your face, relax your jaw, come back to your breath. So slowly, perhaps let your hand help guide your legs back, uncross, readjust, cross to the other side, and I'm going to scoot my hips a little bit over towards that side. Arms can be out, and let those knees fall. Relax your face. Relax your jaw. Feel where you're connected to the mat, to the earth. Shoulders touching as much as possible. Use your pillow wherever you'd like to. And perhaps look to the opposite direction with your neck and your head. As you continue to connect to your breath and for your dedication for this morning's practice. Adjust your shoulder away from your ear if it is close. And breathe. hips back. Adjust, unwind, and we'll move into pigeon. Take one of your legs, cross over so that you're creating a number four kind of with your legs here. The pillow might be helpful under your hips if you like a stronger stretch. Inhale and bring your legs up closer to you, aiming to get this knee a little closer to your chest. So decide if you'd like to try the pillow under your hips. That's kind of a nice way to help you get into this pose better. It's a strong hip opener. Notice if you have any tension in your jaw, let that go, your eyes, your face. And just breathe. Use much arm strength at all or any to just get this stretch a little deeper. Continue to feel your jaw is tightened. You can try just having the tip of your tongue up against the roof of your mouth. That awareness of the tip of your tongue up towards the roof of your mouth should help any kind of a jaw tension, and you can, you know, use that when you're meditating. That helps. Feel free to move in the stretch if you like, or, you know, just notice how it is to be still. This is your practice. Breathe. To roll your ankle around if that feels good. And on your next inhale, gently unwind, readjust. Take a long stretch.
stretch from the tips of your fingers down to the tips of your toes. Bring your feet back up to the other side, the pigeon, crossing one heel over the thigh of your other. Perhaps bringing your pillow back to support a little bit of a different or deeper stretch for you for pigeon. Creating that number four and that just getting prepared to sit in pigeon here for 3 minutes. I invite you to bring your hands to heart center here and just connect to your dedication once more. Relaxing your jaw, relaxing your face. And breathe. May feel quite different than the other, and that's really normal. Pigeon, you're also always invited to move your knee away from you as you gently pull your legs in, just to get a different ways to open. And yin, getting to those deep muscles and fascia. Sitting in these poses longer is really helpful for the body, releasing, elongating your flexibility. It might even help bring up some emotional releases for you again, which is completely normal. So if you're ever needing a good cry or just feeling a cry coming along, just go with it. Breathe. And let your body release whatever it needs to release. To roll your ankle around, on your next inhale, unwind, move your pillow without using it, stretch really long one more time from the tips of your fingers down to your toes. Big breath, and then take up space for Shavasana. Palms up, legs just open, feet open. Connect to your breath. Connect to your intention for today's class, and let this few minutes of Shavasana just integrate the work that you've done. Feeling yourself connected to the mat, shoulders away from ears. compassion for your intentions, your dedication. When you're ready, roll to one side. Maybe taking this moment to give yourself a little hug. Use your hand to push down. Coming into a seated position. Hands to heart center.
Lovely, lovely day ahead. Starting it off this beautiful way to relax, get into our deep muscles and fascia and yin. Thank you for joining me. The divine light within me sees and recognizes the divine light within you. Namaste.